Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a while that since I uploaded a video regarding perfumes, but now I'm back. I'm sorry, it's just that during those times I wasn't able to upload a video. It's because I become busy of preparing my papers and also moving myself out from the city, which is in Cebu City, and I actually in our province right now. And as of the moment, I am actually being quarantined here in this school as to follow protocols given by the government. And it's kind of, this is my 30th day, something like that, or I'm almost going to be released after those days that needed to be quarantined, because I am a locally stranded individual in the city. However, as you can see on the title, this video is about haul of my perfumes collection in this past few weeks or month that I've been collecting and buying perfumes. These are all the ones that I bought out from fragrancex.com and also out from the person I've known that I bought through online, as well as perfumes that I bought in a mall. So, like Ayala Malls and Ezzy Malls when I was still there in the Cebu City. So without further ado, let's proceed. And by the way guys, I'm sorry about my face right now. I know I look like so miserable. It's because I wasn't able to shave yet or to have clean my face. Is because I don't really have the stuffs in here. I don't have really the access. It's just that I completely feel like in a prison here in the quarantine. But anyway, it will be over. It will be over after this quarantine. Okay, so I'm going to show you first the one that I bought, the Fragrance X. As you can see, it's here in the box. I'm already able to open it. And some of these perfumes, guys, I'm just going to show you the my first impression, and some of this I was already able to use it. And yeah, let's see how those perfumes goes with my review. Okay, so the first one that I want to show you is this box. This one is actually this is Paris Hilton, Just Me by Paris Hilton. This is actually a tester. As you can see in the box, it's only plain white, and this bottle doesn't have any cap on. Okay, so the first impression I have in here, since I wasn't able to wear this yet, the first impressions I can give is that this opening note is really, really citrusy, flowery, and it's kind of powdery. And this is really good for day wear, yeah, for a daytime wear. It is absolutely good on a woman because it's a woman's fragrance. Okay, so let me cite the notes of this perfume, guys. It's actually floral, woody, powdery, sweet, and rose. Yeah, so as I've said earlier, it's very flowery, even though I smell a little bit of citrus in here, but the dominating part of this perfume is actually the sweet rose and floral. Absolutely, I can smell tuberose, I can smell ylang ylang, and lily of the valley. Yeah, it's floral, it's really floral. Okay, so the next one that I want to show you is Her by Katy Perry. This one, guys, is actually, I really love how the box looks like, and as good as looking as the box, it is also good looking of its bottle. For those who already know this perfume, or for those who own this perfume, you know already what I'm talking about. Okay, so this is the bottle looks like. It's so definitely cute. It's good for those teenagers that are absolutely fond of this little cat looking bottle, and as good looking as it is, or cute looking as it is, it also has a sweet sweet synthetic smell. Yeah, and I was already able to use this or to wear this, and I can definitely say that it doesn't have that great longevity on it. Like, it's only lasting me for about 5 to 6 hours. I don't know you guys if you have this kind of perfume, but for me it only lasts on my skin for 5 to 6 hours, and I need to spray it again. And as far as you can see here, let me cite the notes. Okay, so as I've said earlier, this is kind of fruit, this is kind of sweet vanilla, and yes, as being shown here in the notes, it is fruity, sweet vanilla, white floral, floral, and powdery. And for me, the thing is dominating in this perfume is actually vanilla and sweetness. And even though it opens with a fruity scent, but the dry down of this is really sweet. Okay guys, that is the Katy Perry perfume. Okay, so next that I'm going to show you is the Beyoncé Heat by Beyoncé. The box that I have in here is actually a tester. I only have the tester because I don't know why did I get the tester if only there's a little bit difference with the one that has an original box in it. And I don't know, Sylvie. But anyway, I also got this from FragranceX.com, and unfortunately the bottle doesn't have any cap on, but guys, this is a really such an adorable bottle. I really like how the presentation looks like of the bottle, and as good looking as the bottle it is, the scent of this perfume is really such a great. This is actually one of my favorite perfumes. It's just that it is fruity and a little bit of floral, and there's also sweetness in there, and for me it's a little bit musky. And let me cite the notes of this perfume. Okay, so as what I've said earlier, this one is a kind of, this one is sweet, fruity, and a floral of course, but it also has balsamic, what's that, balsamic or balsamic, whatever, almond, and a little bit powdery. Yeah, those are all the notes that is present in this perfume. And this, guys, I can definitely recommend this to wear on evening, but you can also go with it with the morning or daytime wear, because it's kind of a bit versatile. Okay, so the next one that I want to show you is the Forever Elizabeth by Elizabeth Taylor. This one, guys, is actually, this is a really floral dominating scent or perfume. I can definitely say that this is full of flowers. And this one is good for daytime wear. And only for me, this one is, can be wear in a specific special occasions, because it has a reminder, like it will really gives you the vibe where every time you smell this, you can think of a specific days or special days that you have in your life wearing this one. Let's say you're wearing this on your wedding day, which is definitely good example of wearing this perfume, since that your wedding day is full of happiness, celebration, full of flowers and tears as well. And it's definitely that time that you are going to think of, yes, this is actually the perfume that I wear in that special occasion. I can definitely think freshly in my mind that those, how special day that was in me wearing this perfume. Yeah, that's how I can explain it. I don't know you guys, but that is how I can definitely think about this perfume. And I'm going to cite to you the notes of this perfume. As I said, this is very floral, and the notes of this perfume is fruity, floral, white floral, powdery, and woody. Yes guys, as I mentioned, there is white floral, not just floral but also white florals, and we know most of the good scent flowers are those white floral, but Anyway, so those are the chords or the notes of this perfume. Okay, let's proceed to the next one. I have here Ellen Tracy by Ellen Tracy. This one has actually, it's a soapy, for me, it's a soapy, fruity vibe. And I kind of a little bit disappointed on me buying this one. It's because even though it's a good perfume, it's just that it doesn't work for me. It doesn't really have that good vibes that gives me or compared to other perfumes. This one for me, I'm actually going to give this to my mother. It's just that it doesn't give me any interest at all. Even though it's kind of cute with its bottle, and I like how they presentation of the bottle, how gold the label here, which is saying Ellen Tracy, but it's just that it doesn't work for me, guys. Even though how I love girls' perfume as well, and I love boys' perfume and unisex perfumes, just that this one really doesn't work for me. But anyway, let's say about the notes about this perfume. This one, guys, is actually floral, woody, powdery, fruity, balsamic, and green notes. Yes, this is actually floral and powdery. Yes, I can definitely tell it's powdery, but it's kind of soapy scent. Okay, now let's proceed on this box in here, which is full of perfumes. And this one is actually the box that came from Fragrantex. And just a heads up, guys, that perfumes that you order in Fragrantex, and I know that for those already able to order in that site, we know that it takes almost a month before it arrives in our houses or in our doors. And in me, as far as I can remember, I already able to order two times, and both of my orders came in me for about 20 to 25 days. Yeah. But anyway, let's talk about the next one that I have in here, which is, this is a very famous fragrance, and this is the Armaf Club de Nuit Intense Man. And I have the Eau de Toilette. And guys, this is really, even though the box itself is that, it has a great scent. I really can smell. I really like the scent of this box, even though it's just a box. And I like how the presentation looks like. It's it looks like a plywood. I know that it's kind of weird, but it looks really like a plywood by the details in here. Yeah, that's how the box looks like. Let's proceed to how the presentation of the bottle as well. And guys, this one is a little bit heavy. As you can see here, it's all black, and there's a little bit diamonds in the cup as well as in the bottle. And it says, here, Club de Nuit Intense Man. And I know, guys, that for those who already know what it smells like, it's the same with the Creed Aventus. And I didn't smell the Creed Aventus yet, the original one, but I was able to smell those inspired perfumes. It's just that those inspired perfumes to this perfume is really the same scent. It's just that this one has a little bit harsh opening of the note, I mean of the scent. It's a little bit harsh, and when it dry downs for about 30 minutes or more than an hour, you can smell yourself in this one. You will definitely good smell. I was able to wear this yesterday, and I wore this around 3 p.m. and until earlier around 7 a.m. I'm still able to smell myself in that perfume. It's like, wow, this is really such a long-lasting perfume. And my brother and sister were able to say, like, oh my god, you smell so good. You definitely smell so good. And I said, yeah, because I'm wearing this, which is definitely a good smelling, and it has a I can tell that there is a liver in here, and the liver is kind of dominating this perfume. By the way guys, as Dave said, this is the number one Creed Aventus clone that ever made in the history of fragrances. And we all know that Creed Aventus is the most historic fragrance that ever made in the history of fragrance. It is definitely a good smelling, it is a beast, and it is dominating perfume that you can smell ever. It's really such a great fragrance. Okay, so the notes of this perfume is actually citrus, fruity, leather, smoky, and woody. Like I told you, it has a harsh opening which is full of citrus. I really can definitely smell the citrus. The moment I spray it on me, guys, I just wanted to give you a heads up. I don't want you to overspray in yourself. It's because it will definitely give you a headache. It's from the smell of the citrus, which is definitely overpowering this fragrance in an opening. The next one that I got in here is a tester of 1 million Paco Rabanne. Guys, I'm sorry. It's just that this is one of my most dream fragrance. But this one, guys, is as I know that some of you already know that this perfume is good for nighttime perfume. As you can see, it's just a plain box, a plain white box, because what I have here is a tester. But as you can see in the bottle, this is how it looks like. Yes, it's a gold bar, and I like how it looks like. I really love how it looks like. The smell of this is definitely unforgettable. You cannot smell this fragrance to other fragrances. Like, it has a, for me, only for me, it has a unique scent itself, and it has a sweet dry down, but the opening is definitely such a master. And what I have in here is actually the Eau de Toilette. There is already an Eau de Parfum of this fragrance. Eau de Toilette has a different smell from Eau de Parfum. They have different notes. Okay, so the Eau de Toilette has actually a warm, spicy, cinnamon, citrus, balsamic, woody, and leather. And I can definitely smell the warm, spicy, and cinnamon in opening note, which the moment you spray it like that, I'm going to spray it in me. Yeah, it's really spicy. And the cinnamon citrusy is already there. I don't know. Just for me, I can smell a little bit of coffee in here. Yeah. For me, there is a little bit of coffee that is present in this perfume, and I definitely love how it smells like. And even though it's a great nighttime wear, but I can also recommend this for you to wear on daytime. Okay, so let's proceed to the next one, which is this one, Nautica Voyage. I was able to buy this in Rustan's and Ayala Mall Cebu. And this one I have here is only the 15L, and it is an Eau de Toilette. Yes, an Eau de Toilette. I really, really love this one. It's one of my favorite. It has a, I know that it doesn't have that much in presentation in the box and in the bottle, but the scent of this fragrance, I can definitely smell the apple, a green apple, and also aquatic vibe. And yes, this is great in daytime wear. Oh man, this perfume is definitely such a great, for me, it's a great perfume. So the notes in this perfume, it's green, fruity, floral, fresh, aquatic, and powdery. Like I told you earlier, it is a green because it has a green apple in it, and it's green and a little bit powdery and aquatic vibe. Yes, this scent is really such a fresh fresh scent. You will definitely smell fresh in this fragrance. I can recommend this also in a women, if you love men's fragrance. This is, for me, it's a unisex because it's not that harsh in smell, and it's really such a good smell. Again, this is Nautica Voyage Eau de Toilette. The next one that I have is from fragrancex.com. As you can see, it has a weird, you know, it or has a weird, it's not a box, but a bag. So, this guy is actually being made around 1975 or 1960s like that, or 19... I really doesn't like how it smells, or the opening note of this one. It's strong, very, very woody. And as you can see, I only got the 60ml, and thank God I only got the 60ml because if I have the big bottle, I'm going to regret buying this. Because I already regret buying this gray flannel by Jufre Bean. However, I like the dry down of this one. It's just that the opening is very strong, woody, powdery, and in a bad way. For me, it's in a bad mixture, and I really doesn't like it, and I don't know why did I buy it. But I'm going to, I guess, just keep it in me. I'm just not going to use it just for, you know, display in my fragrance that I have in me. And the notes of this perfume is actually woody and powdery, very aromatic, floral, and green. Yes, guys, like I told you, it is very woody and powdery. Even though it's aromatic, but still, it's, yeah, for me, it's in a bad way. Okay, so the next one that I have, which I bought in fresh store, physical store in the Yala Mall. This one is Sweet Dream by Shakira. And I like this perfume. It's just that I really don't love that much, but I like this perfume. And the bottle, I love how it looks like. It's such a formation of a star when you put it this way. But the bottle, the cup is, it's plastic. The only glass in here is this one, the bottle. But it is very fruity, very sweet vanilla perfume. I can smell berries in here, a lot of berries, and that is the opening note. And the dry down is actually a sweet vanilla. The notes of this perfume is fruity, sweet, caramel, balsamic, rose, and woody. I wonder why there's no amber, but it feels like there is because I can smell it. But anyway, this is a very fruity, sweet fragrance and a little bit woody. And there is a rose in this present. But guys, I can recommend this for you to a nighttime wear. This one in here is actually good in nighttime wear, but you can also get away with this in daytime wear. It depends on you. This one is quite versatile. But it is recommended for, I can recommend this for you in a nighttime wear. And again, this is Sweet Dreams by Shakira. I have two bottles left in here. And the next one is Hot Eau de Toilette. And this one is a classic smell. This one is really such a classic. For me, it's quite powdery, and I know that for those you are in here, it's a very mom type. It's a mom type perfume. Okay, so even though it was being released in 1997, but still for me, it has a classic vibe. It has a note of an oriental floral, and it has bergamot, Brazilian rosewood, and lemon, and also orange. And there's also apricot, Irish water jasmine, and lily of the valley. And the base notes is sandalwood, amber, musk, vanilla, oak moss, and cedar. But for me, guys, the dominating part of this perfume is actually the lemon, bergamot, and amber. And there's very floral. It's very floral. The next one that I have in here is all is actually only a body mist. It's a Women's Secret Beach Breeze Paradise. And this one is really coconut. I can definitely tell that it's really coconut. I really love how the presentation looks like, as you can see. But guys, this is only all plastic. It has, it really has a gold glitter inside, as you can see. And I really love how the presentation looks like. And in how the presentation looks like, it's also great smelling for me. I don't know what's the, I don't know what are the dozen shows in here, the notes on this perfume, but I can definitely tell you that it is really coconutty floral, and more on coconut vibe. Really, really, such a great smell. But anyway, so that's it for guys for my fragrance haul, and I hope you enjoy watching my review of this perfume. And if you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and like this video, and I will see you soon next of my vlog about reviews. Okay, bye for now.